Don't make this mistake. Indeed. Hey there, I'm Tom Cheswick, and today I'm going to save your soul from the Photoshop gods. Command-Shift-U in Photoshop, otherwise known as desaturation, is one of the worst ways to make a black and white. Today I'm going to show you two great ways to make beautiful black and white images using Luminar Neo. Let's get right to it. Let's open up this image. And first off, let's take a look at desaturation and why it's not the best choice. So if you go to develop in the color panel, go to saturation and just do this. Sure, it makes your image into black and white, but there's so much more control that we have with the tools of Luminar Neo. So let's take a look at a much better method. We'll reset everything. We'll go into the black and white panel. So if we notice this image, we have a green background, a blue sweatshirt, and skin tones. We can control all those gray tones when using black and white tool in Luminar Neo. So let's first convert it to black and white, and we pretty much have that same conversion we did when we desaturated. But now look at this. Remember the green background? We could lighten that, or we could darken it, and it's just affecting the green tones of that image. Control. Same with the blue sweatshirt. We could lighten the blue, we could darken the blue. We get to decide what we'd like. Same with the skin tones. Those are going to be mostly reds or yellows. We could brighten that up a little bit. That's looking so much better than just desaturating. And we still can go back into develop, and we can do smart contrast to really take it up a notch. And now we have a powerful image. If we needed to adjust the exposure, we could bring that up a little bit as well. Now we have an awesome looking black and white image, much better than when we just desaturated it. Now that we have the black and white looking just how we want it, let's do a nice finishing touch for black and white images. Let's go down to the creative section and select film grain. And we can select the amount we want. Let's zoom in a bit. And we can select the size and the roughness. And I'm liking that look, so let's click on film grain and have it set in. Awesome. A beautiful looking black and white image. So let's reset everything and look at the second method of making incredible black and white images using Luminar Neo. I gotta admit, this is probably my favorite way because you have total control, but there are quick and easy ways to do it. So we're going to revert to the original. We're going to go to the presets. And this time we'll look for the monochrome presets. And with one click, you can have quite the variety of black and white images. For this image, I really like the soulful. And we'll click on that. And we'll bring it into edit. So with one click, Luminar Neo did a black and white adjustment, and they raised the reds and the yellows to brighten the skin tone. They added a dramatic filter, details, enhance, skin, and face retouching. All of those with just one click. One thing I love about the presets is even though it applied all these different adjustments, we could go back into any of them. We could up the smart contrast, for example, hit OK, and it's going to apply it. So nothing's locked in. Even though we're using a preset, we can customize it, get the exact look that we want. We can also save the new look as a preset to apply to new images. And once we have the image looking just how we like it, it's so easy to export the image. Luminar Neo also has additional presets as well that you can order from them. And if we go to the search filters, we can put it in black and white and take a look at all the different ones that they have available. So thanks so much for joining me, learning about two quick ways to really make some nice black and white images in Luminar Neo, much better than desaturate. Hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to my channel. This is all about helping you grow as a photographer. So if you have any questions, be sure to leave it in the comments. If you have any suggestions for future videos, be sure to leave those as well in the comments. Until next time, enjoy.